Bletchley Park is where, during the Second World War, the codebreakers of the Government Code and Cipher School worked in absolute secrecy, breaking codes from Germany, Italy, Japan, and other Axis nations. This is a story about the industrialisation of code breaking. At the beginning of the war, there were just a couple of hundred people here working in the existing buildings and in a few wooden huts. Soon they needed to expand as the process became industrialised. The more success they had, the more space and the more people they needed for the machines they invented and the people they needed to operate them. By the peak of war in 1944, as in the run-up to the D-Day operation, there were some 9,000 to 10,000 people working here, and many more off-site at outstations listening and working on bomb machines. As you step out of the new visitor centre, you step into the atmospheric parkland that was ordered to be retained at the beginning of the war as development started to spread across the park and buildings were flying up all over. The first head of the Government Code and Cipher School, Alistair Denniston, ordered that there'd be somewhere for codebreakers to breathe and think and innovate outside of the intense atmosphere of the huts and the blocks. Inside the huts, you should get a sense of what it's like to walk in the codebreakers' footsteps. You should feel what they felt when they went in there to work, the intensity of the atmosphere, the darkness and the rudimentary nature of their working environs and how important that work was.